गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर सोनिया तिवारी फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन अरविंदो मेडिकल कॉलेज इंदौर. टुडे वी विल डू चैप्टर नंबर 12 फ्रॉम पार्क, दैट इज मेडिसिन एंड सोशल साइंसेस. आई होप आई विल कवर ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स एंड ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर. एंड एज यूजुअल देयर इज अ रिक्वेस्ट टू कीप अ कॉपी एंड पेन टू स्टार्ट विद इट. Social sciences refers to a composite of several disciplines, right? The three disciplines or these disciplines of social science are anthropology, economics, political science, psychology and sociology. These are the disciplines which comes under the social science. Now, what are the social factors which influence the health of people? There are various social factors that will influence the health of the people, like they are demographic, economic, political, legal, religious, educational, technological, communications, migration, urbanization, life expectancy, marriage, fertility and the role of women. Now, what do you mean by the term sociology? Socio means society, logos means science, and sociology is viewed from two angles. First is, it can be seen as the study of relationship between human beings and how these relationships changes or vary in different parts of the world and at different times. And second part is concerned with the study of human behavior, right? First is the human relationships at various countries, at various times, and second is the human behavior. Or broadly speaking, as I have written here in red color, that broadly speaking, medical sociology include study of the medical profession, of the relationship of medicine, public health and the social factors. Now, what are the concepts, various concepts in sociology? We will study them one by one, or in short, we will cover the important definitions like society, community, social structure, social institutions, the role, the socialism, socialization, social control mechanisms, customs, culture, acculturation, what are the standard of living, dynamics of the social change, social stress, social problems, social pathology, social surveys, case studies, field studies, communication and social defense. Now, what is acculturation? It is a definition quite often it is asked in your Viva Voce. So acculturation means culture contact. Contact between two people with different types of culture. There is diffusion of culture both the ways. How it can be? Through trade and commerce, through the industrialization, through the propagation of religion, education and context. Now, this is the enumeration. In this slide, you can see enumeration of various social problems in India. So, they are poverty, crime, disease, alcoholism, venereal disease, mental illness, narcotic addiction, housing, divorce, population growth and increase in the number of old people. That is your geriatric problems, right? This is very important. Again, I am repeating, they are the social problems in your country. They are often asked in your Viva Voce, right? Poverty, crime, disease, alcoholism, venereal disease, mental illness, narcotic addiction, housing, divorce, population growth and increase in the number of old people. Now we are coming to another term that is called social pathology. It is used to describe relationship between disease and the social conditions, as you can see in the definition itself. And social pathology of accidents, diabetes mellitus, cardiovascular system cases, chronic bronchitis have all been the subject of recent investigations in medical literature. Now, next definition which we are coming is an important definition, that is social obstetrics and social pediatrics. I am going to tell you the definition. The study of interplay of social and environmental factors and human reproduction, right? Social factors and human reproduction going back to the precipitation or even premarital period, right? So the factors can be, various factors can be there, like age at the marriage, the childbearing period of a woman, then their family size, level of education, economic status, the customs in the family, and the role of women in the society. So when you talk about social factors and the women of the reproductive age group, right? And it can be the period before reproduction also, okay, fertile period. So that definition denotes the social obstetric. Now coming to the next and the, I think the last definition, that is the social pediatrics, right? So the application of principles of social medicine to the pediatric age group, right? To obtain a more complete understanding of the problems of children, in this you have to understand the problems of children in order to prevent or treat disease and promote their adequate growth and development. You have to see the growth and development of children. You have to study the social factors along with the problems of the children. So that is social pediatrics. So I hope the two definitions are clear for you. One is social obstetric, other is social pediatric. They are also often asked in your viva voce. Now coming to the next definition, that is learning. It is a relative permanent change in the behavior that occurs as a result of practice or experience, right? It means you have to acquire something new, new knowledge, new technique, new skills, new experiences, etc. That is called learning. Now what are the conditions which will affect the learning? So it can be intelligence, it can be your age, your learning situation, in which situation you are learning. You are learning from the institutes, by the teachers, by the textbook, by the AV aids, etc. Then motivation, somebody is motivating you or not. Like they are giving you encouragement, praise, they are giving certain rewards and they are doing praising of your success story. So that is motivation. Then physical health means what? That if you are deaf and dumb, if you are something, sickness is there in your thing, chronically sick or something, you cannot learn. Then mental health, as we have already seen in mental health, that certain kind of worries, anxiety, fears, interference with learning, they will not allow you to learn. So conditions affecting learning will be intelligence, age, learning situation, motivation, physical health and mental health. Now what are the types of learning? So there is a mnemonic for type of learning, that is CAP. C-A-P, CAP. CAP means, C stands for cognitive, that is your knowledge. Affective means attitude and psychomotor means your skills. Now what are the various theories proposed by the psychologist for learning? So learning can be by the conditioned reflex. One can be by the trial and error method. Learning can be by observation. Then learning by doing, learning by remembering, and learning by the insight. I hope you understand the various theories which were proposed by the psychologist. You should remember few names of it. That's enough. Then coming to the next heading, that is intelligent quotient, or you can say IQ. IQ, first of all, the formula is asked in the various pre-PG question. And your viva voce also, it is important. IQ is equal to mental age upon the chronological age into 100. Now, these are the various levels of intelligence and their IQ range. Few I have underlined which were important. Like idiot, the IQ range is 0 to 25. Normal range for the IQ is 90 to 109. Superior is 110 to 190. And near genius, if your IQ is 140 and above, then you are near genius. Otherwise, if you are normal also, it will be 90 to 109. Now, what is the definition which they say about the IQ? IQ is the measurement of the quality and the potential of your intelligence, right? One is the formula. As you can see again, the mental age upon the chronological age into 100. But if you see in the language point of view, it is the measurement of quality and the potential of intelligence. Higher the IQ, the more brilliant the child and is more capable of higher performance at the school age. Now, what are the chief values of discovering a child's IQ? We'll see the points. Those with the low IQ can be taken aside for special education, right? Then those with higher capacity can be selected for education in keeping with their capacity. Intelligence tests determine right time to enter the school. इंटेलिजेंस टेस्ट इन मेंटेनिंग एडजस्टमेंट ऑफ पीपल टू हिज वर्क, देन सिलेक्शन ऑफ एप्लीकेंट्स फॉर कॉलेज एंड प्रोफेशनल्स एट स्कूल, यूज ऑफ इंटेलिजेंस टेस्ट इन द एजुकेशन गाइडलाइंस एंड यूज ऑफ इंटेलिजेंस टेस्ट टू द थेरेपिस्ट. जस्ट यू कैन रीड ओके दैट व्हाट आर द चीफ वैल्यूज ऑफ डिस्कवरिंग अ चाइल्ड्स आईक्यू. देन कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट, दैट इज द टाइप ऑफ फैमिली. सो इट इज अ प्राइमरी यूनिट ऑफ ऑल द सोसाइटीज, द ग्रुप ऑफ बायोलॉजिकली रिलेटेड इंडिविजुअल्स लिविंग टूगेदर एंड ईटिंग फ्रॉम अ कॉमन किचन. बायोलॉजिकली दे आर रिलेटेड, दे आर लिविंग टूगेदर एंड दे आर ईटिंग फ्रॉम अ कॉमन किचन, दैट डिनोट्स अ फैमिली. बायोलॉजिकल यूनिट मीन्स वॉट, द फैमिली मेंबर्स दे शेयर अ कॉमन पूल ऑफ जीन्स. सोशल यूनिट मीन्स वॉट, दे शेयर अ कॉमन फिजिकल एंड सोशल एनवायरमेंट. एंड एज सब एपिडेमियोलॉजिकल यूनिट मीन्स वॉट, फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग सोशल सर्विसेज एज वेल एज कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव मेडिकल केयर. नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू द साइंटिस्ट, वॉट डज दे डू? फैमिली ऑफ ओरिजिन इज देयर एंड फैमिली ऑफ प्रोक्रिएशन इज देयर. सो फैमिली ऑफ ओरिजिन डिनोट्स वॉट? It denotes into which one is born, where you are born, that is your family of origin. And family of procreation means where one settles down after the marriage, because for girls your family changes after the marriage. So that is family of procreation. One family is that, another family where you are born, that is the family of origin. Now what are the basic models of nuclear family? Life cycle, there are various models, or you can say the phases of family life cycle. What are the phases? So there are six important phases, as you can see in the slide. One is formation. Beginning of the phase is what? Marriage to the birth of first child. ठीक है, extension means क्या? Birth of first child से लेके birth of second child और last child. Complete extension means what? बर्थ ऑफ लास्ट चाइल्ड से लेके फर्स्ट चाइल्ड, अब आपका लीव होम, ही हैज गॉन फॉर स्टडीज और समथिंग लाइक दैट. कॉन्ट्रैक्शन मीन्स वॉट? फर्स्ट चाइल्ड लीव्स द होम टिल लास्ट चाइल्ड लीव्स द होम. कंप्लीट कॉन्ट्रैक्शन मीन्स वॉट? योर लास्ट चाइल्ड लीव्स द होम एंड योर फर्स्ट स्पाउस डाइज. एंड डिसोल्यूशन ऑफ द फैमिली विल अकर व्हेन योर फर्स्ट स्पाउस डाइज टिल द डेथ ऑफ द your second spouse or death of the survivor. ठीक है, that is the extension. So these are the phases. Please try to remember them. The family life cycle: formation, extension, complete extension. Then you have contraction, complete contraction, and the dissolution. Now what are the types of family? In our country there are three various types of families. I hope everybody knows: nuclear family, then you have your joint family, and you have your three generation family. So now we'll study one by one. In short, nuclear family consists of married couple and their children. While they are regarded as dependents, occupy the same dwelling place, absence of parents, grandparents, your uncles, aunts, relative, okay, the married couple is living and their children are living, that is called the nuclear family in one line. Then your joint or extended family, it is a kind of family grouping which is common in India. It consists of a number of married couples. Ek hi married couple nahi hai, number of married couple, unke bacche. All the property it is held in common, right? All the authority is given to the senior male person of the member. Family relationships enjoy your primacy over marital relationships, right? Union is a strength. As you can see, they are standing in tough time as well as in your good times. So they have a common kitchen, they have a common purse, and the senior member, male member, holds the authority, and you can say that all the property is common, and number of married couples and their children are living. So that is your joint family or the extended family. Now what is the three generation family? It occurs when young couples are unable to find separate housing, accommodation, and continue to live with their parents and have their own children. Like the parents are there, the married couple is there, and the married couple children are there. One, two, three. Three generations are there. that is 3 generation. And in joint family, what is happening? One or more couples are living with their children. They have common kitchen, common purse. The male member, senior most, is the head of the family, and everything you have to share, good times as well as bad times. That is your joint family. 3 generation married couple, and your parents and your children. 3 generations are living. And nuclear means only one couple and their children are living. That is nuclear. Now, what are the functions of the family? First function is what? It gives you a residence. If you have a family, you have a residence. Then there is division of labor. Division of labor means what? The male person is going for work. Nowadays, it's not so. Females are also contributing, but they have given the division of work, that the male will work, the female will do the day-to-day activities and bring up the children. Third is your reproduction and bringing up of the children. Fourth point is socialization. Socialization means what? What are the cultural patterns which you are practicing, like eating habits in the family, cleanliness, your dressing sense, your way of talking, your behavior and your attitude. Then fifth is your economic function, that is inheritance of the property. What property your family is having, your certain farms are there, or certain shops or dwellings are there. How you are going to share and distribute among the children. Then you have your social care. Social care is very important. So I am reading it, that it gives the status in the society to its member. They will say, "Is family se aata hai bhai ye to." Right? The other society members, वो लोग पहचानने लगेंगे, अरे ये फलाने के घर से आया है, ऐसा आया है, अरे ये उनका पोता है, उनका बेटा है. So it gives a status. Your each family has its own status in the society, and all the members have their status. Protect its members from insult and defamation. Regulation of marital activities of its members. Then regulation to a certain extent, political, religious and general social activities. Regulating sex relations through the your taboos, etc. Now, what are the family in health and disease? So, child rearing, physical care of the dependent young in order that they may survive to adulthood and perpetuate the family. You have socialization, that is the process where the individual develop qualities essential for functioning effectively in the society. Personality formation, that is capacity of the individual to withstand stress and strain. Whenever you have, your family stands with you, right? Then care of the dependent adults, those who are sick, the elderly people, then the women are there, then the children who are not working, they are still studying. You have to take care of them. Then stabilization of adult personality, like your family acts as your shock absorber. Something will happen, right? Bad or good, first thing you are going to tell to your family. Why? Because you know they are the shock absorber. They can tolerate your each kind of happiness and as well as your stress, right? No other member of the society will do so, right? So family is like a shock absorber to the stress and strains of life. Like you can see, they have told about the stress, that is the injury, illness, birth, the death, the tension, the emotional upset, worries, then anything, anxiety, economic insecurity, if something is like that, they will discuss and they are going to deal with it. Then you have the familial susceptibility to the disease, like hemophilia, color blindness, diabetes, mental illness are through the families. Broken family, one where the parents are separated or where the death has occurred of one or both the parents. That is broken family. And mental deprivation, most dangerous pathogenic factors in the child development. Now he'll rear up and he'll be brought up like that only. If one parent is death or if both the parents are death. That is broken family, and it gives certain impact on the your bringing up of the children. Then last is your problem family. Problem family means every time in the family they will have certain problems. Like you will see backwardness, poverty will be there, mental illness can be there, emotional instability can be there, character defects and the marital disharmony can be there. Certain couples will keep on fighting, or certain couples will they will destroy the environment of your family. So I think this is important. What is family in health and disease? you have to take care of all the points. Again, I am just brushing up. One is child rearing, socialization, personality formation, care of your dependent adults, then stabilization of the adult personality, family susceptibility to disease, certain disease like hemophilia, color blindness, diabetes, mental illness, etc. You have one type of family, that is broken family, and you have problem families. Now coming to the next definition, which is most important, often asked in 5 marks question, that is operational research. Operational research is defined as application of scientific methods. I'm focusing on the word scientific methods of investigation to the study of complex human organization and services. If you have to study human organization and services, you have to apply scientific method for its investigation. One is concerned all the time with the activities of a group of people with the purpose of inducing beneficial changes. Now, main objective is the kya hai? Operational research ka is to develop new knowledge about the institutions, programs, use of facilities, the people working in these activities, and the individuals and the communities covered by them or served by them. ठीक है, तो study of complex human organization के लिए और services के लिए हम लोग scientific methods of investigation use कर रहे हैं, that is operational research. अब इसके steps क्या हैं operational research के? As you can see in the slide, सबसे पहले ये हो गया formulation of problem. ठीक है, ये planning cycle से भी थोड़ा बहुत मिलता जुलता है. फिर collection of relevant data, पहले problem देख लिया, फिर data collect कर लिया. अब डेटा कलेक्ट हो गया है तो डेटा को एनालाइज कर लेंगे और हाइपोथेसिस बना लेंगे कि कैसे होगा. ठीक है, क्या करना है. फिर आएंगे सॉल्यूशंस पे, फिर चूज करेंगे ऑप्टिमल सॉल्यूशंस, फिर करेंगे टेस्टिंग ऑफ सॉल्यूशन कि सॉल्यूशन जो आपने चूज किया है उससे कहाँ कहाँ क्या क्या प्रॉन्स एंड कॉन्स है. और लास्ट हो गया आपका इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ सॉल्यूशन टू द होल वर्किंग सिस्टम. ठीक है, फेजेस आ गए समझ में ऑपरेशनल रिसर्च के. सबसे पहला फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ प्रॉब्लम, फिर हो गया डाटा कलेक्शन, फिर हो गया एनालिसिस ऑफ द डाटा एंड फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ हाइपोथेसिस, फिर हो गया डिराइविंग द सॉल्यूशन, फिर हो गया चूज द ऑप्टिमल सॉल्यूशन एंड फोरकास्टिंग द रिजल्ट, फिर हो गया टेस्टिंग ऑफ सॉल्यूशन, फिर हो गया इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन इन द होल सिस्टम. ऑपरेशनल रिसर्च टीम में कौन कौन लोग होते हैं? पब्लिक हेल्थ एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर होता है, स्टैटिस्टिशियन होता है, एपिडेमियोलॉजिस्ट होता है, स्टैटिस्टिशियन एंड अ सोशल साइंटिस्ट भी होता है. ठीक है, फिर व्हाट आर दी सोशल प्रॉब्लम्स? आई थिंक आई हैव कवर्ड देम इन द प्रीवियस स्लाइड. इन इंडिया सोशल प्रॉब्लम्स क्या क्या थे शुरू में ही हमने कवर कर लिया है. नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट, दैट इज कंज्यूमर प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट. ये कब आया था? 1986 में आया था. और इन्होंने क्या बोला था? प्रोवाइडेड कंज्यूमर्स अ फोरम फॉर स्पीडी रिड्रेसल ऑफ देयर ग्रीवियंसेस अगेंस्ट मेडिकल सर्विसेज. आया समझ में? ये रिड्रेसल देता है ऑफ द ग्रीवियंसेज अगेंस्ट मेडिकल सर्विसेज. इन इंडिया पीपल वर नॉट गोइंग टू सिविल कोर्ट्स. व्हाई? बिकॉज दे वहां फीस लग जाती थी बहुत ज्यादा और एक केस को लड़ने के लिए 8 से 10 साल लग जाते थे. ठीक है, पार्लियामेंट प्रोवाइडेड ऑल्टरनेटिव क्विक एफिकेसियस एंड इकोनॉमिक रेमेडी एक बताया कि जिसमें डिसीजन 3 से 6 महीने में आ जाता है और कोर्ट की कोई फ्री फीस नहीं लगती है. कॉपरा, कॉपरा एक्ट. ठीक है, 6 राइट्स क्या थे कंज्यूमर के? राइट टू सेफ्टी, राइट टू बी इन्फॉर्म, राइट टू चूज, राइट टू हर्ड, राइट टू सीक रिड्रेसल एंड राइट टू द एजुकेशन.